I tell them the page numbers. Tell you one thing, I am so glad to be able to worship the Lord in a country that we can still come together, we can still praise Him, we still have the freedom together in His name. I praise the Lord for that, because a lot of countries you can't do that. A lot of places you can't do that. A lot of churches you can't do that. They'll show you the door. You get a little happy in the Lord and they'll be ready to show you the door. I'm glad we got freedom today. Freedom in Jesus.
Amen.
Sister Misty, Brother Gavin, Sister Tanya, Brother Austin.
Well, we're just glad to see you, Brother James. Man, we're glad to see y'all here this morning. We just came here to worship God. I know it's hot. The air conditioner keeps throwing on me for some reason. But you know what? Hell's going to be a whole lot hotter.
That's right.
Sister Tanya, hell's going to be a whole lot hotter than what this place here is.
Thank the Lord we got two Tanyas today.
Amen. We just appreciate each and every one of you for being here. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer. And I know we all got many needs this morning. We got lost loved ones. We got sickness in the families.
Amen.
And I'm going to ask Brother Daniel to come up here and take up prayer requests this morning for us.
My daughter goes to Louisville on the 9th, Thursday, to get her MRI results on her spine for scoliosis, and they'll tell us whether or not she's going to have surgery.
Email.
Remember my son, he has to go to the doctor, and remember him that he'll get right with the Lord looks too late.
Anybody else?
I'm going to pray for all the lost souls because they don't know Jesus.
Amen.
I want to ask if y'all could remember me in prayer. I had a surgery last Tuesday. They opened me up and couldn't finish. I have to do it again. I just need prayer, courage, and strength.
Remember me and Joshua. Remember my Uncle Tucker because he's fixing to have to have surgery also.
Anybody else have one? Anybody else?
Remember Robbie in prayer. He's really feeling bad this morning. He has to work again tonight. So remember him, and remember a friend of mine. She found out that her baby has spina bifida. I can't say it right, but she's still pregnant with the baby. So just pray that God will move and work in that womb, because I know he's able.
Amen.
That's right.
Anybody else?
Also remember Misty, she was out on strep throat. She's getting over it, but she needs to be right now.
Yep, she don't feel good at all. If not, anybody got an unspoken prayer request, but lift up your hand. Remember all these prayers. Yes, God, in the name of Jesus. for each and every request, God. We ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to ask Sister Casey come on up here and sing a song for us. A song or two. Whatever God lays on her heart.
I started singing this song and I've about wore it out. But Sister Cassie asked me if I would learn it. And it's always spoke to my heart. I don't like to sing anything unless it really ministers. I feel it in my spirit. But it's always spoke to my heart. But I was afraid that I wouldn't be able to play it. And the Lord, I sat down one day and the Lord just showed me the keys. It was keys I had never played before. And just listen to the words of it.
Oh,
alive.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Sometimes it takes a mountain, brother, but sometimes all we got to do is just go over that mountaintop, brother Adam. When we get over that mountaintop, glory to God. Glory to God, I don't feel the Lord in this place. I had this place 13 years ago when God was in this place. And it's been anointed. Glory to God, it's been prayed over. And we're here to have church this morning. Glory to God, we're here to let God be God this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Cassie, you got one? Hallelujah.
I'm going to testify. And I want this microphone because I want everybody to hear me good. Most of y'all know I was diagnosed with melanoma back in May. And I had surgery in July. And some of y'all I've seen and talked to, and some of you ain't. But after my surgery, I couldn't raise my left arm but like shoulder high. For about 2 months, Lord had to fix my hair for me. I couldn't pull it up. I couldn't use my arm like I needed to. And I know he probably got aggravated because I'd always tell him, I would say, it's my hair in the middle because I wanted it in the middle and the back. And I couldn't move my arm, and if I raised my arm up, it would fall back down.
All right, come on.
And I went to Mississippi, and this preacher was down there. And after the church service was pulled over, he asked Miller, he said, do you think your wife would care if I prayed for her? He said, no, she wouldn't care. And that brother, I didn't know him from nobody, and at that time I didn't know where he was lived or his name or anything. But he was from Savannah, Tennessee, which we were in Mississippi in a strange land. We didn't know anybody much but the pastors, you know, and the co-pastors and stuff like that. But that brother, he named off about 10 things that I had been having problems with, and one of them was nerve damage in my arm. And when he said, you've got nerve damage in one of your arms, I looked at Miller and he looked at me. And I know God showed him that. And he prayed for my arm. And my arm works fine now.
With my soul to give my all for.
Thank you.
subject. If he wants it, we think we, you know, that we want him to answer our prayers, then we have to live for him. Because the Bible plainly tells us that we have to live for him. For him to hear and answer our prayers. The Bible plainly tells you, it says, God heareth not sinners, but if you'll be a worshiper and do his will, he hears you. He hears you. A lot of people will say, well, I'm praying, but if they're not living right, the scripture tells us God heareth not sinners. He hears the repentant sinner. But after you repent, then he hears your prayers. But if you're in and out and sinning and deliberately sinning, God, the word of God tells us that God heareth not sinners. That's scripture. That's not my word. That's not Miller's word. That's God's word.
Amen.
And that's what we have to go by. You tell me. I praise your Lord.
Praise the Lord. Ain't God good?
Amen.
Man, I tell you, I've done been blessed this morning.
That's right.
Glory to God. We're going to go ahead and just get into the Word of God this morning. Let God just move. Glory to God. God is wanting to do something to His people this morning. He's telling them, hey, I want to do something for you this morning. Amen. I want to do something, glory to God. You know, I've been praying and studying. And I studied this for a little bit through the week, but I've been out here working, and for the last 2 weeks been working on the building. Working on the building for my Lord, for my Lord. Brother Austin, been working on the building. I mean, I've been painting. I've been cleaning chairs. We've been putting carpet down. We put linoleum rug down in the bathroom last night, and had a man come here. A sinner man came here last night and put the linoleum rug down for us, and he put the carpet down for us, and he said, be praying for me. He said, I feel something when I came in here the first night, put this carpet down, and I said, we sure will. We'll be praying for you. Glory to God, I believe you'll be here before it's over with, Sister Casey. I tell you, we got some more people that's been emailing, texting, saying, hey, we want to know when we can come, when you're going to have services, and I tell you what, I'm looking for this place to keep growing, and the landlord done told me he would tear this wall out and we go 20 more feet over this way if we have to, but we're just going to let God be God this morning. I came here this morning for one thing this morning, was to tell the church something. Glory to God, this is not my church. It's not Brother Wayne's church. It's not Sister Norris. It's not Sister Connie's, but it is God's church. And when we get that in our mind that it's God's church, and that you can feel free in God's church, glory to God, where there's love, there's unity. And where there's unity, there's love. And glory to God, that's what we want in this place this morning. That's what we want in here. We want people out here in this world to know that they can come into a place that is God's.
Amen.
Too many churches. This is my church. This is my church. Well, this ain't my church. This is God's church. And it's your church. Glory to God, it's your church. It's same as it is mine. Because we've done this for y'all and for God. Hallelujah. God said if we would lift him up, he said, I would draw all men unto us, Sister Casey. I wanted to come and be with you last night, but we was out here trying to get this all ready to go. But I tell you what, we appreciate the Lord this morning. If you got your Bibles, turn with me to Leviticus chapter 6. I could ask my son-in-law to pronounce that for me, but it might not have went over too good for you. But I went and heard him the other night. Drove all the way on the other side of New Haven to go hear my son-in-law preach. And he done a fine job. He done real good. Hallelujah. Got buzzing out of this thing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Bible says in Leviticus chapter 6 and verse 9. Let's go to verse 8. If you won't stand for the reading of the word for reverence of God, not me, but of God. Hallelujah. If you're able, if you're not able, that's fine. Glory to God. The Bible says, And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, command Aaron and his sons, saying, this is the law of the burnt offering. It is the burnt offering because of the burning upon the altar all night until the morning. And the fire of the altar shall be burning in it. And the priest shall put upon his linen garment and his linen breeches, which shall he put upon his flesh, and take up the ashes which the fire has consumed with the burnt offering on the altar, and it shall put them beside the altar, and he shall put off his garments and put on the other garment and carry forth the ashes without the camp unto a clean place, and the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it. It shall not be put out, and the priest shall burn wood upon it every morning and lay burnt offerings in order upon it, and he shall burn thereon the fat of the peace offering, and the fire shall never be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. Shall ever be burning upon the altar, and it shall never go out. Heavenly Father God, as I come to you, once again, God, to be able to stand, God, behind your sacred desk, Lord, God, to be able to preach the infallible word of God, I pray, Lord God, that you would anoint me this morning, God, that I'll be able to feed the sheep this morning. I pray, God, that you would anoint me, God, take a call off the altar and purge my lips, that I'll say what thus saith the word of the Lord. I pray, God, that you get me out of the way, and let the Holy Ghost come in, and let the Holy Ghost be the preacher this morning. I pray, God, you have me behind the shadow of the cross, God, that the world won't see me, but they'll see Jesus, God, behind me, Lord. I pray, God, that you would move. I pray that you would bless this morning. I thank you for what you've already done and what you're already going to do, God. And God, we give you praise this morning. And God, we give you thanks and honor. And the church would say,
amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. The Bible says here that Moses, and the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, command Aaron and his sons, saying, this is the law of the burnt offering. It is the burnt offering because of the burning upon the altar all night until the morning. And the fire of the altar shall be burning in it. And the priest shall put upon linen garment, and his linen breeches shall he put upon his flesh, and take up the ashes which the fire has consumed, which put the burnt offerings upon the altar, and he shall put them beside the altar.
Yeah.
And he shall put off his garment and put on another garment and carry forth the ashes without the camp unto clean place. And the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it, and it shall be put out, and the priest shall burn wood upon it every morning and lay the burnt offering in order upon it, and he shall burn thereon rain. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Moses told, glory to God, the word of God. He told Aaron what to do. And he said, the priest shall put on his garment and go into the tabernacle. In other words, he's going into the place of holies of holies. And the Bible said that he put on his garment upon his flesh, and he went in. He put upon his linen breeches, glory to God, and he went into the house of God. I want to tell you today, we got people that have come into the house of God. Glory to God, they'll wear skirts from up to here. Glory to God, you can't look at them because they want you to try to lust at them. But can I tell you, if you got the fire of God burning inside of you, you can close your eyes and say, devil, you're a liar.
Man,
Sister Casey. Glory to God, the Bible tells us, he says right here, he said, the priest shall put on his linen garment and his linen breeches. I looked the word up. Breeches means trousers. Trousers means pants. And the Bible said that God spoke unto Aaron, and he told him, he said, I want you to make linen breeches for your sons and their sons and their sons and their sons and their sons from generation to generation. Glory to God, God commissioned that. And I said, God, I want this altar here to burn with fire. I want the Holy Ghost in fire to fall upon this little building. I want to see souls saved. I want to see people sanctified. I want to see them filled with Aaron's Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And he said, and he shall put upon the flesh and take it upon the ashes which the fire has consumed. Some of y'all probably feel like this stuff, your fire's been flickering a little bit. Your flames flickered just a little bit. And you're thinking, man, I've been going through some things. I've been going through some bad things. The devil's come at me. The devil's throw this at me. And the devil's throw the kitchen sink at me. Well, the devil is God. He ain't got so much power that people makes him think he's God. Glory to God, he's only got what God allowed him to have. And that's it. But God's got all power over heaven and earth. Glory to God, and he can bruise the devil's head. Glory to God, he said we can bruise him. And the priest went in there, Brother Wayne, and he consumed with the burnt offering upon the altar, and shall put them beside the altar. He took the ashes, and he took them, and he set them beside the altar. And can I tell you what ashes can do? Brother, the ashes, you can take them, Brother Adam, and you can take a fan or a piece of cardboard and start going like this right here. Brother Wayne, and guess what happens? The flame begins to start flickering. And the flame begins to get bigger. And it begins to get hotter. And all of a sudden it begins to come alive again. Them ashes, Sister Casey, they begin to come alive. God sent me to tell you this morning, you might think you got ashes, but you begin to take the word of God and you begin to flame it. Begin to... Hallelujah. Glory to God, they say. Oh, Brother Miller, I don't talk about that fire. Oh, I don't talk about stuff like that. Oh, don't you preach about the blood. Don't you preach about the Holy Ghost. No, we just want the Bible said it's the Holy Ghost. Jesus said it himself. He said, I'm going to send you back a comforter, and his name shall be called the Holy Spirit. No. Jesus said his name shall be called the Holy Ghost. And he'll be your teacher. He'll be your guider. He'll lead you into all truth.
Amen.
He won't ever lead you astray.
Amen.
Oh, but some people say, oh, Brother Miller, I want what you got, but I don't want to live like that. Well, man, you got to live like I do if you get what I got.
Amen.
Sister Mary, you got to live like you when they got what you got. Glory to God, Sister Casey. Glory to God, they can't live any other way. You can't live a halfway life and think you can make it to heaven. The fire won't burn in a halfway life. Brother Adam, God spoke to me and said, tell them, don't let the fire go out upon the altar. Don't mean it mean just this altar. He means it home. You got an altar at home. Get down the side of it. Brother, if you have to get out by an oak tree every morning, get down beside that oak tree and say, Lord, it's me. I've come to you this morning. God, I'm making me an altar right here. You give me an answer.
Amen. Amen.
Oh.
That's right.
Oh, it's not just a little old 5-minute prayer.
Amen.
Oh, it's a concerned prayer.
Yes.
Oh, glory to God. The Bible said, a righteous man availeth much.
Amen.
Glory to God, if you get down serious with God and you begin to pray and get the fire begin to burn,
yes,
you out there in live stream,
yes,
glory to God, you can get the fire burning in your life. I know some people can't come to the house of God. Some of them were sick, but they're watching my live stream. You can get your fire burning. Get on the altars. Glory to God, the Bible said,
amen.
Brother Wayne, the Bible said, get a hold of the horns of the altar. Oh, glory to God. Oh, Brother Austin, that means to get a hold of it. Hold on tight. Say, you know how a cowboy would do? Man, they'll get on that bull, they'll take that rope, and they'll wrap that around and wrap it around until it's real tight. And they'll hold on. And that bull will begin to buck. It'll begin to jump. And a good cowboy will ride that bull. He'll stay on until the time is over. I want you to know something. God said, get a hold of the horns of the altar. Said, and he shall put off his garment and put on another garment. Oh, yes, Lord. If you're a sinner, you got a dirty garment on. If you're a backslider, guess what you've done? You took off that good garment and put on your old garment. You're back out in sin. Huh? The Bible tells us, he said he took off his other garment. In other words, he took off his old earthly garment, Sister Casey, and he took it off, and he put on that spiritual garment. Glory to God, because he knew he was going somewhere. Brother Josh, he was going to the house of the Lord, where the fire burned, Sister Tanya. Glory to God, he was going there. To serve God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I thought, as he began, Brother Wayne, I just imagine as he began to take off that outer garments. When you was a sinner, Brother Adam, you came to the altar. You took off that old earthly clothes. The Bible said the old man dieth out. Behold, a new man comes in. That old filthy garment that you had on, you won't have. You don't have it no more.
That's right.
You put on a robe. righteousness. You put on a garment that Jesus had given you. Glory to God, he said that he was coming back after one that didn't have a spot, wrinkle, or a blemish. What are you talking about, Brother Miller? I'm saying some people need to get off the earthly garments and put on the spiritual garment that they can let the fire begin to burn, Sister Casey. Let the fire begin to move in your life. And let God's begin to move in their life. Hey, glory to God, you talk about seeing somebody. Glory to God, you can walk into Walmart and somebody say, man, they on fire for God. Tell watering it down. Sugarcoating this altar.
That's right.
Brother Daniel, he said, I'm tired of them going around saying you can live any other way and make it to heaven. Oprah Winfrey thinks there's other ways you can make it to heaven. But the Bible said there's only one way, and that's through the shedding of the blood. That's through Jesus Christ himself. He is our gateway. Glory to God, he's the only way, the truth, and the life. Glory to God, there's no other than him. I don't care what Oprah tries to tell people. I don't care how much they want to listen to that garbage. I'm going to tell you, it's sin, and sin will take you to hell. God's a loving God. God is a gentle God. God ain't a God of hate. God ain't a God of wrath. Well, read your Bible. The Bible said he chastised those who he loves. Glory to God. And he said, I am a jealous God. I'll have no other gods before me. In other words, I am him. And nobody else can take my place.
That's right.
And Jesus said, to get to the Father, you have to go by him. They had a wedding, Sister Tanya. And the master of the house sent them out, said, you go out and get them to come to the marriage. Sister Emmy, and he said, you tell them that I want them to come to this marriage. Now, these are supposed to be Christian. Okay. Supposed to be the righteous. Said, you tell them I want them to come to this marriage.
Help them, Lord.
Brother Adam, they went out and they began to tell them. And here we go.
Help them, Lord.
I can't go to church. I just bought some cows and I ain't proved them yet.
Help them, Lord.
I just bought some land.
All right.
I ain't proved it yet. Began to make excuses. Well, I can't come. Just like people do today. I can't come. I can't come. No. I can't do it. Let's just use Brother Jeroboam. Well, Brother Jeroboam, I just can't come to your church today because me and my wife ain't had no time to walk. And we've been with kids all week long, and we just ain't been able to do nothing. Brother Jeroboam, would it just be all right if we don't come to church Sunday? Would it just be all right if we just not come and we take Sunday and go out and go to the lake and get out there and swim half naked? And would it just be okay, Brother Jeroboam, if we do that? Oh, but Jesus said, they came back and they said they made excuses. One said, I have got a wife and we just married. And Jesus, they began to make excuses. Brother, they began to say things. And when they came back, the master said, well, I tell you what I want you to do. He said, I want you to go out here to the highways and to the byways and into the hedges and compel them to come in into these spirits. And they went out. And they went out and got the alcoholics. They went out and got the drug addicts. They went out and got the prostitutes. They went out and got the adulterers. And they brought them into the marriage. Glory to God. You know what? He said, if anybody comes in without a wedding garment on, cast them out into the burning fire where they'll burn forever and ever. I want to tell you, can't let the fire go out of them. They went out to the highways. They went out to the byways. They went plumb out to the hedges. And they grabbed them, Brother Wayne. They got the sick, the halt, and the lame. The ones that people walk by and go, get out of my way. Get out of my way. I don't want you around here. No, we don't want you. But you know what they did, Brother Wayne? They went and they got them. Brother Austin. They went and they got them.
Right.
Come here. And they brought them in.
Yes. Help the Lord.
They brought them in. They brought him in.
Yes.
Brother Jeremy, they went and brought him in.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And they brought him in.
Yes.
And they brought him in.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Lord.
They went out to the highways and the hedges.
Right, yes.
And they brought him in.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Brother Kevin, come on up there. He's bringing you in. Sister Tanya, come on.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank
He's bringing you in.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Thank you. Brother James, hallelujah.
Yes.
He's brought him in.
Yes.
He's brought him in. He's bringing them in.
Yes.
Oh, you say, Brother Bill, what are you talking about? Oh, glory to God, he brought them in. This one right here might have been an alcoholic. This one right here could have been a drug addict. This one right here could have been an adulteress. This one right here could have been a prostitute. This one right here could have been a meth head. But Jesus said, you go bring them in. And he brought them into the marriage. And they had a wedding party. All right. And I tell you, Jesus said, you say, Brother Miller, you're crazy. No, I'm not. I'm telling you what God did.
Yes.
Right. And they went out and they began to bring them in.
Yep, right. Lord.
Come here, Brother Wayne. You and Brother Adam, come on in. You go outside that door right there.
Yep, Lord.
Go on outside that door.
Bless the Lord.
Now you listen to me, boys. Come here. You got the wedding garments on, okay?
Yes.
And God said, don't let them come in to that marriage if they ain't got a wedding garment on. You see these big boys, right here? Y'all don't let them come in this place.
Yep,
you stop them. Y'all try to come on in. They trying to come into this place. See what you can do? You can hold them out. You can get them outside of the way. Okay, y'all can be seated. Hallelujah. See, you tell me, Sister Casey, that we're supposed to be workers in the vineyard.
Yes.
Glory to God, we're supposed to be bringing them in.
Yes.
We're supposed to be going out here and saying, hey, Jesus is alive and well.
Yes.
Bring them into the marriage.
Amen.
And let them know that there is a fire burning inside of us that the devil cannot throw out. He cannot go across the bloodline.
Right.
If you've been bought by the blood of Jesus Christ, Satan cannot. He cannot enter in. He cannot come across the blood. Jesus went to that old cross and they put him on that old cross. The devil sat back and said, ha, 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 ha. Look at what I have done.
Yep,
and I even used his own people.
Yep,
right. That's right.
I took his own disciple and had him to betray him. See what I've done?
Come on.
See what I have done. You see, Sister Mary says, look at what I have done.
Yes.
And when them old Roman soldiers began to nail them nails in his hands, the devil said, there's one. Man, there's three. There's two. Oh, how about God? How about God? They put his feet together. He was really laughing. Oh, I've got him now. I've got him now.
Yep, Lord. Yep, Lord.
Brother Quinn, you're staying right here.
Yep, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Put your arms up like that. Put your cross. The devil said, see, looky here, people, what I've done to your Savior.
Yep, Lord. Yeah.
All right, come on.
Tell him about your Savior now.
Yep, Lord.
That thief was on the other side. said, if thou be the Son of God, if thou be the Son of God, come down off this cross.
Yep, and Lord.
Yes.
The devil knew who he was.
Amen.
That old thief. Thou be the Son of God, come down off that cross.
Yep, and Lord.
Save yourself. Did you know Jesus could have called 10,000 angels?
That's right. That's right.
And they would have came down and took him off that old cross.
That's right.
But you know what?
Right. Help him, Lord.
The one over here said, Jesus, thy son David, remember me.
That's right.
When thou entered
into
the
kingdom.
That's
right.
Amen. Oh my God. A thief. Hanging on the cross.
Yes.
He said, remember me. And Jesus said, this day thou will be with me in paradise.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
And the devil said, I can't have that. I can't have him saying that.
Help him, Lord.
And the devil sends that Roman soldier up. And he says, sticks that sword in him.
Right.
And the Bible said, out came blood and water. And that blood began to run down. And it began to make a river.
Mm-hmm. All right.
From the old cross.
Yes.
And it began to run, Sister Mary. And that blood's still running today.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Yes. That blood is still running.
Yes, it is.
And the devil said, say, what I've done now. And the Bible said Jesus looked up and said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
That's right. Amen.
And the Bible said, he said, Eli, lama sabachthani. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? And the Bible said that he gave up the ghost.
Right.
In other words, he died. And the devil said, I got him. I got him. I got him. I got him. I've got him where I want him. Brother, come here, man. Brother Adam, I'm going to use you. Brother Jeremy, I'll take Jesus here. Take him back here and lay him in his tomb. Lay him back here in that tomb, right there on the floor back here. Sister Mary, they said they took him and they put him in a borrowed tomb. And they laid him down. And the Bible said that they put a napkin across. In other words, they put a white linen cloth over him. They covered him up.
Yes.
That's right.
And the Bible said that he laid there for 3 days. But on that third day, he sent it into hell.
Yes.
He went down into hell.
Yes, it is.
And the Bible said when he went down in there, Satan began to tremble.
That's right.
Amen.
He began to quake.
Yes.
He began to shake. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hand me those keys down there, Brother Jeremy, underneath my base. He began to shake and tremble.
Heaven,
began to shake them old keys and he come to Jesus. Come here.
Heaven, Lord.
Jesus come and what did he do? Satan said,
"You're going." That's right. That's right.
And he reached out and Jesus said, "What?" He come and he took those keys.
Amen.
Of death, hell, and grave.
Thank you.
And he was in the garden.
Yes.
Mary. Sister Time, come with her.
Help him, Lord.
Mary and Martha came to the grave. The stone had been broken down.
Yes. That's right. That's right.
They looked in. Y'all look in there. But he's gone.
Yes.
Two angels that were standing beside him. Look over here. Turn me over there. There was two angels standing beside him, Brother Wayne. And brother, them angels said, they said, what'd y'all do with him? Talk to the angels. Say, where did y'all do with Jesus?
Yes.
Where did you do with him?
Right. Right.
And the angels said, he's not here.
That's right.
Them Roman soldiers were standing there asleep.
Yep.
God came by, them angels said, and the stone just said,
that's right.
Amen.
Help
him,
Lord.
But then,
bless him, Lord.
Mary,
help him.
To get the world back. And she seen Jesus. She didn't recognize him.
That's right.
She wanted to know where Jesus was at. But Jesus spoke to her.
I'm not dead, I'm still alive.
I'm not there.
Yes.
And Mary automatically knows that's my son.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Yes.
Bless him.
Bless him. Yes.
Brother Austin, he's alive.
That's right.
He is alive.
He is.
Jesus is alive and well.
That's right.
And the old devil trembled and he quaked and he shook. Brother, the old devil thought, man, I messed up now.
That's right.
He done exactly what he said he would do. He said, on the third day I will arise. And he said, I'm going back to my father.
Right.
And he said that he was going to watch Sister Mary. He said, he's telling us. He said, I'm going to go back. I must go back to my father. He said, when I go to my father, he said, I am going to send you a comforter.
That's right.
And his name will be called the Holy Ghost.
Right.
And the disciples, they wanted to see that comforter. They wanted to know what Jesus was talking about. And Jesus told them, since you go to Jerusalem and you go and tarry in the upper room and you pray until you receive power from on high.
Yes.
He said, you go in there and you begin to tarry. The Bible said that about 300 of them begin to start out upon their journey. And they begin to go just like churches today. Glory to God, they'll have a big old church, Sister Mary. And next thing you know, you go in there and they ain't got nobody, hardly. Fall off like fleas.
Right.
Sister Casey, and when they got there, guess what? Only 120 was in the upper room. They didn't go in there and talk about Yvonne. They didn't go in there and talk about Big Macs, quarter pounders, whoppers, ice cream. They went in there with one thing on their mind. They went in there for that promise. That Jesus said, I'm going to send you back. He said, I'm going to send back to my Father. And I'm going to sit by my Father's side. He said, and I'm going to send you somebody. And he's going to come into your life. And he's going to be a teacher. He's going to guide you. He's going to put a fire inside of you. He said, a Holy Ghost and fire. Shut up in your bones. There's nothing that can take a place of it.
That's right.
And God said, don't let it go out. Don't let the fire go out.
Amen.
Yes.
Right.
On the altar.
Amen.
I didn't know it was going to go this way, but Jesus did.
That's right.
Amen.
Brother Wayne, he said, he's alive.
Right.
That's the name of our church. He's alive.
Yes.
He is alive.
Right.
And if you let a fire go out, it's dead.
That's right.
If you don't flame, if you don't fan them ashes, it's going to go out.
That's right.
And it's going to die. And God said, don't let the fire go out.
That's right.
Even though you got ashes set beside it, begin to fan them.
Yes.
Glory to God, take one of those things that they used to use to make their blacksmith. They take that thing and they would pump it like this to keep that fire burning. They wouldn't let that fire go out. We need to let the fire of God begin to burn. There's a song no one sing, the fire on the altar. Glory to God, don't let the fire on the altar burn out. Don't let Jesus be dead in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Man, I'll tell you. Brother Wayne, Elijah was on Mount Carmel. Sister Casey, the devil was on Mount Carmel. Baal, the god, Baal. And they built him an altar, brother, in heaven. Elijah told them how to build it. Elijah built his altar the same way. They done them the same way. They prepared them. They killed their bull up. They laid them upon the altar a certain way that had to be laid. And Sister Mary Elijah stood back and said, y'all go ahead. Y'all, the first God that answers by fire will know that's who we're going to serve.
That's right.
Well, they began to pray to Baal. Then the Bible said, got up on the altar. They began to jump on the altar. Rocks. They begin to take things and begin to cut themselves. Their own blood burning on the altar, putting on the altar. Baal! Baal, we've served you! We have served you! Did you know that's where the demon of cutting came from? Where's your God at now?
Amen.
That's right.
Make fun of him. Hey, where's your God? Up there cutting yourself like that. Don't you know better?
Amen.
Well, your blood ain't gonna do no good. Why did you do it? Well, just like them. Well, they prayed and they collared and they cried and they cried, Brother Wayne. Finally, they gave up. Elijah didn't stop there.
No,
Brother Daniel, he told him, he said, Daddy, I'll get you a shovel. He said, I want you to dig trenches all around this altar. They began to dig trenches all around that altar. He said, then I want you to dig some ditches out through there. And they began to dig ditches. Sister Mary, he didn't stop there. He said, now I want you to go take them big barrels and I want you to fill them up with water. And I want you to bring them and I want you to pour them all over this altar. I want you to soak it down. I want it wet. I want it real wet.
Right.
And they begin to pour that water upon that altar. And he said, not only that, I want you to fill them trenches around that altar with water. You begin to fill them up till it's full. He said, then I want you to pour it in them ditches. You fill them up until they're running over. And then God, Elijah began to pray unto God. And he said, God, you answer me. God, you show them that you are real God. God, you begin to show them. And all of a sudden, the fire of heaven came down upon that altar. And it consumed that altar. And not only did it consume that altar, the Bible said it lapped up all the water that was in the trenches and that was in the ditches. Why? Because the fire of God is real and it'll never go out. It'll never go out. The world is trying to put it out.
That's right.
big. But you can say some bad words and have some.
That's right.
Oh, it ain't gonna hurt nothing. But God said, they can't put me out.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus said, I'm alive.
Amen.
And they cannot take me out.
Yeah.
I am alive and well. I dwell. I walk among them every day.
Amen.
He sits high and he looks low. Brother Wayne, some days when I look at the clouds, Sister Casey, I like taking my phone, take pictures of them. Because Jesus went away on the cloud.
Yeah.
And the angel of the Lord said, the same Jesus that you see go away is going to come back again.
That's right.
In like matter on that same cloud that he went away on, he's coming back on.
Yeah.
And I like to sit and look at the clouds. We were on our way to Bowling Green yesterday. Man, there was a pretty cloud out there. I wanted to get a picture of it. And then a song came to me. The clouds opened up, and there stood Jesus.
Amen.
One day, the clouds is going to open up, and this world's going to see him.
That's right.
And he said, every knee and every tongue shall bow.
That's right.
And confess that he is Jesus. That he is the Lord of lords.
Amen.
And the King of kings.
Yes.
And she begins to say, what God has given me today.
Things of love may rage around us and numbers.
Some of you here probably don't understand about that Holy Ghost that I was talking about. Can I tell you, it's a gentleman. What's a gentleman? Somebody that don't miss, they just genius. Somebody that don't fuss. word today has helped someone.
Amen.
Oh, Preached this morning. You know, Brother David, I thank you for allowing God to use you. You know, a lot of people don't do that. They get scared.
Amen.
Anybody else ever got scared trying to serve over?
Amen.
I do that every day.
That's right.
Bless the Lord.
But I tell you what, I got a God that helps me.
That's right.
And a lot of people that won't do that. They don't, want, right. they don't want God to help them. They won't let Him help them.
Right.
You know, I don't read the Bible like I should. A lot of people don't.
Bless the Lord.
But it's all we can do to try our hardest. Give everything we got. Now, sometimes all we've got is not enough.
That's right.
But how many know what God's got is more than enough?
That's right.
Amen.
I just want to thank the Lord for saving me. Thank you for the Holy Ghost. I thank you for my wife and my beautiful kids and the one that's not here yet. I thank you for you, David. You know, funny story. Just before you did that, I went back there to the bathroom and got something to drink for little man, and or got some water for mixing milk with him. And I was praying, you know, God, just help me, give me some strength, give me something. And I was feeling discouraged. And
hallelujah.
Then I come out of the bathroom and God uses David to talk to me. Mm-hmm. Now I don't know about anybody else, but that ain't coincidence.
That's right. Amen.
That's God.
That's right.
You know. If we'll humble ourselves and pray, we'll read, ask God for understanding, ask Him for wisdom, ask Him to help us read the Word, and whenever we read it, you know, somebody told me a long time ago that whenever we read, before we open the Bible, if we'll just pray, God, help me to understand Your Word that I'm about to read. Whatever part I read,
right,
come on, help me to understand.
Amen.
You know, we need to do that with everything. Not just the Bible, but, you know, whenever we're going down the road, you know, help the Lord just help me get there safely.
That's
just
right.
That's just like His house we've been looking at and trying to get. And thank the Lord, I believe we're going to get it. I know we're going to get it. We just got to work out a couple kinks. But, you know, just like this house. I've been praying for a house, man, and my wife's been praying for a bigger house, because we're in 3 bedrooms, we got 4 kids, 6.5, 5. It'd be kind of cramped, 7 people living in a 3-bedroom house.
Yeah.
It's cramped now with 4, well, no, and 6 of us, sorry. I've been everywhere in school, so y'all can give it to him. But, you know, that's just like this house. We've been praying for it for a long time, and, you know, it took me a long time to obey the Lord and trust Him. And I was saved when I was 16. And I was excited. I got saved at a youth conference down in Orange Beach, Alabama. It was on a Tuesday night. And it was actually the week after I turned 16. And I was all excited, you know, come back to tell my mom what God had done, how He moved in my life just in a week, and in a couple days I hadn't seen her. And, you know, at the time, my mom wasn't real big in the church. But I was excited anyway. I didn't care what the devil was at me at the time. I was excited. I was on fire for God.
Yeah.
And things happened. I backslid. I left the Lord. I mean, you know, a lot of people, you know, something bad will happen to them. They think God's left them. God's forsaken them. God don't never leave us. We leave Him.
That's right.
And it's up to us to humble ourselves. You know, there's people praying out there praying for us. And with people praying for us, you know, God moves in our lives. But we've got to listen.
That's right.
Nothing's going to happen if we don't listen to Him.
That's
right. So we've got to listen and humble ourselves and get down on our knees and pray to God. You know, cry out to Him. Just like the song says, your cries have awoken the Master. It don't matter who you are, what color you are, where you're from. You cry out to God with everything you got, He's going to listen. He does listen.
That's right.
He's never sleeping on us. We sleep on Him, but we shouldn't.
That's right.
But, you know, we've been praying about this house, and, I backslid, so I rededicated my life to the Lord. And after that, you know, I got in the Word. And got to praying, you know, got to truly trying my hardest to live for God. And you know, glory to God, he's moved in our life. He's blessed us with fixing to get this six-bedroom house, three-bathroom.
Amen.
You know, we're going to have plenty of room. We've got a full basement. It's more like a garage, but, you know, storm comes, tornado comes, we're just going to the basement. We ain't got to worry about going anywhere else. Mm-hmm. But I tell you what, something I told my wife, you know, it don't matter where we're at, whether we got a basement or not. Mm-hmm. God wants us, he's going to get us.
That's right.
No matter if it's a tornado or strong wind, a tsunami, hurricane, it don't matter what it is.
That's right.
It don't matter if we're in the basement trying to hide from it. God wants us, he's going to get us.
Yep.
So, no, he blessed us, you know, getting his house. And I just thank him for that. I thank you for Brother David, for obeying God and just letting God use him. You know, the devil's really been trying to discourage me. Like I told some of y'all, wasn't there last week, Misty and Daniels, when we had church, but you know, I told them last week, you know, it's like last couple of weeks, the devil tried to jump on my back and I gave him a piggyback ride. Got discouraged, got down. But glory to God, I got down on my knees, I cried out to God. My cries woke the Master.
Amen.
He's really moved, he's really helped me. He's helped our family. He's, you know, a lot of people think God's dead, you know, God's not moving, that we're in the last days and everything, you know. Yeah, I believe we're in the last days. I believe he's coming very soon.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm gonna tell you what, God's not done.
Right.
God's not dead. He is alive.
That's
he's
right.
Still moving, and he's going to continue to move.
Amen.
No, we got to get our minds focused on God. We got to get our minds focused on God's. You know, the more we focus on him, the more he will move. The stronger he'll move. But yeah. I just thank God for saving me. I thank him for everything he's doing in our life and our situation. You know, we've got a couple things going on, but I just thank him for everything he's doing, everything he's going to do. I thank you for David. I thank you for this church. And just glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Somebody else.
I just want to thank y'all and praise y'all for all the hard work y'all done. I will tell you, I feel right at home here. I've sat here and I've needed this.
Bless your
church. I've not sat in a church in a long time that I felt equal to everybody.
Bless the Lord.
I thank you all for this place that y'all opened up for us to worship and making it feel like it's our place.
Amen.
And everybody's welcome. I'm going to give this little testimony. I had heart surgery on Tuesday. I've been miserable all week. I'm not one of these. I've stayed in bed. I've cried. I was down on you know, prayer. I just couldn't pray enough to get an answer. Went to town for the first time yesterday I ever drove. Got sick. Was in pain. And last night I prayed. God, I'm going to go to church. I knew this was the first time I was going to have it, I wanted to go. I woke up this morning with no pain.
Amen.
Yes, sir, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In a better mood than I've been in a while.
Hallelujah.
And I knew it was meant to be for me to be here. I heard what I needed.
Bless the Lord.
I got some strength and courage back today.
That's right.
I love you all. And
I love y'all.
What you've done.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I want to thank the Lord for the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
That's good enough for me.
Amen. Somebody else.
I want to thank God. I got saved when I was a child, and I backslid as an adult. And then I got cancer. I got thyroid cancer. And it's sad that that's what it took, but that is what it took. to get me back on my knees and repenting to the Lord.
Bless her, Jesus.
And that's what I did. And God healed me of the cancer.
Amen.
I've been cancer-free for 5 years now.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Somebody else.
We had church.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, we have.
We threw down up in here. Y'all, we're going to need more chairs because it's going to fill up.
Amen.
I want to thank the Lord for what I felt today. We have put a lot of time and hard work into this church just so we can come to worship. We wanted them to feel free and let God move. And I really thank God. And Dad's been praying for a long time. This is not something we just done on a whim. We actually prayed. And we put places before God, and God answered every one of them. So we knew that it was meant to start this church. We're here to help people, and God wants to bless and do miracles in a mighty way. And Brother Adam's adding to me, he said, you better hope you in the spirit if you get slain out, or you're going to be... get hurt for certain. Well, I tell you what, I was in the spirit or I'd done be hurting because I didn't know I was going to be the first one there to knock her forward.
Yeah, there's no padding under this carpet.
There you go.
Going to make her hurt,
man. Brother Austin. This is my buddy. This is my adopted grandson. And I'm proud of
him. Amen.
Amen.
Thank the Lord for waking me up this morning.
Amen.
I woke up this morning and I told him, I said, as soon as I woke up, my eyes, I didn't even open them yet. I just said, Lord, I'm going to get some more of you today, one way or another.
Amen.
And so all day today, right before we left, I felt like I should have grabbed something before we left. And then now I see why. I need a sweat rag pretty bad. I just want to say that if you didn't get something here today, then there is something severely wrong with
the culture. That's right.
Wide open.
That's
right. If you was able to sit in your seat and not say a thing this whole service, I believe this should be your new home.
That's right.
Come on. I just want to say that when I walked out of here, I didn't even open my eyes the whole time around. And I could feel there was somebody over there in that car. And they left, so I could go over here and open my eyes. I ain't never felt somebody look so crazy at me.
Sorry.
I walked back here, my eyes closed, my arms up, I walked around the side and walked back, and I could feel that they were sitting there saying, what in the world's he got a hold of? I got a hold of something good today. And this church ain't gonna be the only one that's gonna get it, because as we go out, we're going to shine our light to all of us. Today, that revival is going to happen today.
Amen.
And it's going to happen when the church gets on their knees and starts praying and seeing people as well. Then will the Holy Ghost of vision come down.
Come on.
Amen.
Bless you, Lord.
Right.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't want to drag the service out, but if you want to testify.
You know, I still want to thank the Lord, too. I know I've got a bit of now, after all, since I come back to businesses. God healed me. I used to have really bad, this guy, like Sam was having kind of a mom. We went to the Labor Day Fest, and I didn't know this man from Adam.
He was a different man.
He was a different, totally man. His name was Brother Darren Howe. I didn't even know his name until afterwards. But he kept coming back to my daddy. My daddy was praying, the Lord let him call her out. And I've been praying to get back what I used to have. I mean, I used to pray and pray and pray. And I mean, I wouldn't pray to lay my hands on somebody with demon possessed and cast it out of them. That's just the way I was. And I went back like that. And I've been praying for that for a very, very long time. And that guy didn't know me, and he would walk back to my daddy and look, and he'd go back. Then he'd walk back to my daddy and he'd look, and he'd go back. Dave thought, well, he's going to speak to me. God's going to have him speaking to me. Then he'd come back a third time, and he looked, and he'd call me out. He said, Sissy, I don't know you. He said, but he took his hand. He was standing in front of me, and he just took his hand up, and he went like this. Just, he didn't touch me. He said, but God's showing me you've got digestive problems in your system. I have been sick with digestive problems since I was a kid. A lot of stuff I could not eat. It made me sicker than a dog. I mean, from dairy to spicy to just pretty much anything, I got where I pretty much ate bland foods. And since that night, when God touched me, he said, and also, God's showing me that you have a hunger that you want to be filled, and God's going to fill that. And I really believe God's doing that. And he just barely touched me, and I was gone in the spirit. And from that day forward, I can eat anything I want to, and it's not bothering me not one bit. And I thank God for that. And you know, the doctors told me, because I had been taking physical therapy, and it was scary, and you know, the devil put fear in my life for it, because they told me, because I have a neck injury that I had since I was a kid, and they told me I could not raise my left arm anymore. I couldn't sleep on my left side. I couldn't do this. I couldn't do anything like that because it stopped my heart. And they said, if you do that too long, you're just going to go on out of this world. And I was feared for that. The devil thought, well, you can't do nothing like that no more. So he put fear in me. And my sister would message me. She said, Sissy, please remember, don't sleep on your left side. And I went and got prayed for that night. I felt like going up with Joshua and getting prayer. And ever since that night I've come home, I've been raising my arm. It don't stop my heart. I've been laying on my left side.
Amen.
And I'm still here today. So I want to give God the glory and the thanks for that.
Amen. Brother Josh, everybody, I want y'all to meet our media guy. He's our media, he does the websites, he's got us on YouTube, he's done got us all set up, done got the church sign designed, and he's done a good job. I want him to come up here and testify. He done a good job the other night preaching too.
Amen. I just want to thank God for this service, this church, everybody here. I really felt the presence of God here today.
Amen.
I'm the one, like, I like to stay back there away from everybody, but I was back there and clapping my hands while they're all up. I was glad to see this altar full.
Amen.
And, you know, God's blessing me, as in when I took the calling up, I never thought he would open doors for me. And he has started to open doors.
Amen.
And I'm not going to say where I've been invited, but I've been invited to a church that goes all with radio. And I praise God for that. He said, whenever you're ready, you let me know, and you can come up here and preach.
Amen.
So I'm working on a message now. God puts a message on me, and it takes forever sometimes to get the full message, because you have to study.
Well, that's right.
And when you study, God will give you that.
That's right.
And the message I'm working on, it says, where's your praise?
Amen.
We should be praising God every
right.
day for
it.
You know, when we wake up, we should praise the Lord.
Amen.
And some of us just like, you know, we go and, you know, we go out through the week and we don't give God praise for nothing.
Right.
He woke you up every day of the week.
Right.
You should be praising the Lord.
Right.
You're not doing something wrong.
Right.
Maybe you need to be up in here that this altar,
yeah, come on,
give him praise or give your life right.
Come on.
God's putting that message in my heart, and it's a little bit worse than one when I preached on Thursday. And, you know, I just praise God for what He's doing for this church and all these people here. We had a head count, and it was 30 people here this morning.
Amen.
That's a lot of people for one, the first service.
Wow.
I'm praying that God will fill this church.
Yeah.
The plane seats open. And we can fill this church up. We got a few more seats left.
Yes.
And so, I praise God.
Amen.
Absolutely. A lot of y'all don't know, this boy right here has been a big help to us. He's helped us.
Amen.
He stayed here last night till after
5 o'clock.
He said, "I'm going to go home, just drink a pot of coffee and stay away." I said, "Nah, you go home, get you a little sleep." But he has really been a blessing.
Yes, he has.
And I appreciate him. And I prayed this morning. I said, "God," I said, "you bless him. You bless him abundantly, because he has really helped a lot.
Yes,
he's done a lot for us. Financially, he's helped us some. And I know he don't have that much, but God's going to bless him back."
Amen.
Amen.
And his little sidekick right there, I call him his little sidekick. God has placed that boy in Adam's
life. That's right.
And the Bible said, follow somebody that follows Christ.
That's right. Amen.
Follow me as I follow Christ.
Amen.
Adam's living a good life in front of him. I just want him to testify.
I just want to thank God for being here tonight. I was here last night and this morning, both.
Yeah.
But I just want to thank you for the spirit I felt in here this morning. I really don't know what I was saying, because I can say a lot. But
what's on your heart?
I just want to thank you for what he has brought me from.
Yeah.
And what he's brought me to.
Amen. Yeah. That's right.
Because it was about 3 years ago.
Bless the Lord.
That was ready to want you life.
Bless the Lord. But God has more better plans.
That's right.
When I went to church and heard him preach, I was out of church. About 3 years ago, I brought my wife back to God.
Yeah.
Amen.
And I've been serving him ever since.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
I went to God, I go to the fire department.
Yep.
Now I've been appointed as a chaplain for the fire department.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
You know, I went back through the service, and I was thinking of all the things that I've done and everything. And you know, after I got out of high school, I went to school to be an auctioneer. Believe it or not, I talk so slow. But you know, as I sat there and I thought about that, and I always think about what you say about we've got to go out and spread the word of God to other people, you know. As going to school, I've been an auctioneer. You know, trying to spread the word is like being in a big, loud crowd. And you know, God's kept telling me, he said, the only way to spread that word is get louder than the enemy.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
You know, I just want to praise him, and I want to thank him for what he's done for me. I can't thank him enough.
Amen. Blessing,
Lord.
You see, what for all my Christian friends? You know, I heard a while back ago when I was sitting there and I was going through what I was going through. I, Amen. Jesus knew I was in trouble. And you know, I just want to thank you for my family. I want to thank you for my little girl that I've got.
Yes.
Yeah. I just can't thank you.
Amen.
Like she sung, there's just so much I can thank you for.
That's right.
That's all I've got to say for it.
Everybody has come to be with us this morning. Next Thursday night.
This Thursday.
7 o'clock. Invite somebody. Bring somebody out. The 30th. Did you say the 30th?
Last Thursday
of this month, we're going to have a dedication service for the church. We're going to dedicate the building to the Lord.
Yes.
Hopefully our signs put up by the end. How'd you like Gavin's drum playing?
Good.
Okay. He's done gone. I thought about, he said, well, I got somebody now can fill in with me when I get hot. We appreciate everybody, Brother James.
Well, apparently God's not going to let me leave without saying something. I feel like I'm taking all over. I hate to make everybody stay, but one of the things when you were doing the garments that we had and we had to have Wayne and them outside, I was like, dear Lord, how am I supposed to stop someone about four times my size? Then I got thinking, it's not going to matter how big they are. If he gets me in the spirit, if he gets me to do what he's doing, I'm going to be able to stop them.
That's right.
Is that I say this every time. I don't know why, but one of the biggest blessings I've ever had is my family.
Amen.
Amen.
Say this every time because God put me places to where I need to be, and He finally got me a place I need to be.
Amen. Blessing.
Another blessing is my brother. Amen. We don't always get along the best, but
that's right. He'll teach you.
Blessing.
Still love him no matter what.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That's all I have to say.
Amen. Anybody else?
I thank God for all of our kids that we're bringing them up right.
Amen.
No service tonight. We just wanted to have this service today as our opening. She's had something planned for over a month. And we didn't know we was going to get this at the time, but God knows what was needed today.
That's right.
If you want to go to church somewhere tonight, find a good church and go to it. We're going to go to Brother Russell Mills tonight over in Scottsville. Airline's going to be singing over our gospel group. Airline's her favorite group, and her and him's been talking on the internet. She's been praying for him. Because he has to have dialysis two or three times a week, and sometimes they take off, how much did he say they took? About 32 pounds of fluid off of him the last time.
He's younger than me.
And a lot of times when he goes out and sing, he takes three or four different suits with him in case he's swelling. He'll go out and he'll put a suit on it with him. But we love y'all. Emmy, you and your, what's your name now?
Danny.
We love y'all. We love y'all. Appreciate y'all for driving all the way from Horse Cave over here. We appreciate that.
I just want to say, you know, it was wonderful to be here for your first service. You know, my wife asked me, you know, I thank God for saving my soul. You know, I don't mean to take up too much of your time.
Oh, it's all right. Go ahead.
You know, I was an alcoholic, drug addict. Most of my life in prison. Church I go to, we got this thing set up. It's to reach out to people with addictions.
Yeah.
You know, if you have a church not reaching out for the lost, then it's lost.
That's right.
Thank you.
Amen. You know, the Lord has blessed me with a beautiful wife, three children, wonderful home. time I look at cross, there's one thing I like about that cross. I don't see Jesus hanging up.
That's right. Amen. He's not there.
Yeah. But he's still alive.
That's right. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. We got one thing we got to do. Well, anybody else?
Had a birthday.
Our assistant pastor's wife's birthday was yesterday.
Has anybody else had a birthday?
Anybody else had a birthday?
Addie.
Abby.
Abby.
How old are you? 8 years old. All right.
Don't ask me. I'm a lot older than that.
Well, I won't say that. Let's put this way. She's... I done went over, so I didn't go back up and go over again.
Happy birthday to you, a happy birthday.
Misses today.
Brother David, you know, you hear people say, I got to go to church. I get to go to church. It's like it's a chore, you know.
Yeah.
I get to go to church.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Dear our gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for the service we had today here to the Lord with the fellowship presence. Lord Jesus, we just ask you, Lord, to be with us for the rest of the day. And tonight and in the days to come, Lord Heavenly Father, we love you, we thank you, we glorify your name, Lord, for all the things you've ever done for us and will do for us, our Lord. We just thank you so much. In your glorious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.